Discounts and offers made by online and offline players seem to have served the purpose, and companies have chipped in as well, of course. Customers lured into buying new products. Xiaomi is one such player which managed to catch consumers' fancy, selling more than 5 million devices in just 7 days. A decent chunk of those were television sets, and that's where Dixon Technologies comes in. The Delhi-based company supplies the LED screens to Xiaomi. And of course, I reckon that the other brands too could have done well. So joining us right now to talk about the bump up is the company's managing director, Mr. Atul Lall. Mr. Lall, good having you. Thanks much for joining in. Just wondering, I mean, Xiaomi seems to have taken the
Thank you so much.
Consumer's fancy, and you are a big supplier to there. Just wondering whether this is starting off this, is this a bit of a one-off, or do you reckon that the sales for consumer electronics have just not dipped at all?
Well, we are very fortunate and that we have a very strong relationship, a strategic relationship now with Xiaomi on the LED TV side. And I think Xiaomi offers a great value proposition. They have very deep reach in offline and online both, more in online. And they've done exceedingly well, which has given us a significant fillip in our consumer electronics vertical. So they are a very, very robust value proposition for the Indian consumer.
Yeah, so I'm just wondering, so your key clients, of course, I believe Xiaomi is one, which, unless I'm very wrong, accounts for about 65% of your sales by volumes. Now, with the kind of market share gain that Xiaomi has had, has that proportion increased for you? Part two of my question is, because of the kind of fillip and the response that it is getting, are your quarter two numbers as well as your projections for quarter three and quarter four moving up, Mr. Lall?
Well, I'm in a silent zone, so I can't talk specific numbers.
Sure.
But, yeah, the
understand.
Q2 numbers are extremely strong. Q3, let's see how it pans out, because it's going to be post Diwali. Q4, I think, is going to come back to normal, but till Q2, the numbers have got a significant fillip.
And is it only restricted to Xiaomi television LEDs, or are some of the other clients doing well too? Because quite frankly, there are two ways to look at what's happened in the Amazon and Flipkart online sales data that has come out. One is that there has been a remarkable push up, bump up, tier 2, tier 3 cities and towns have done well. The other way to look at it is, it's only consumer electronics which are doing the same. The others aren't quite chipping in. How would you dissect all of this?
Well, in our case, all the verticals have done significantly well. And I think we have had extremely good Q1, Q2. But as far as the growth in in our case, the growth is coming more because of new customer acquisitions, because please appreciate we are an outsourcing company, so it's the growth is significant, but coming more because of customer acquisition, and the growth is across all the verticals that we are into.
Right, Mr. Lall, I mean, I just want to carry this point forward. Now, if you were to look at the LED, the TV segment, where the dependence is pretty heavy on Xiaomi, compared to the other segment, which is lighting, which is not as big as the TV segment, but it still has a considerable chunk in the part of your sales. There, it's diversified. So the dependence on Philips as a single client has reduced from 76% to 47% because of, you know, other clients coming in. You've got you've got Polycab, you've got Bajaj, you've got Panasonic, Wipro. So the dependence on Philips has gone down. With regards to the bigger segment, which is the TV segment, do you anticipate yourself trying to reduce dependence on Xiaomi and getting in more clients in that fray?
Well, we follow a twin strategy. The first is that with all our anchor customers, we work hard to enhance our stickiness. We work hard to gain a larger share of their business. That's a very, very important part of our strategy. Second, across all our verticals, customer acquisition is the key. So we keep on working on acquiring new clients in every product category that we are in. And so is the case in LED televisions, that we are working on the similar strategy. So you'll see some customer acquisitions happening shortly.
All right, to reduce dependence on Xiaomi. Got that. So let's talk about also, you know, capacity and how you're placed with regards to your expansion plans. You know, with the corporate tax cuts, how is that? How much of a positive is that for you? And will you be deploying more money in terms of creating additional units for yourself, because you'll get some more tax deductions on that as well?
Yeah, so that's an ongoing exercise. We have recently added huge capacity in our mobile vertical, which is going to go on stream in end October, early November. We are also further adding our capacities in the washing machine vertical, a new product category of top loading. That should become operational in next fiscal by Q3. Same is the case in television. So in televisions also, another round of capacity expansion will take place shortly. So that's a ongoing continuous exercise. However, at the same time in Dixon, we are extremely conscious about our capital allocation, and it's always going to be focused.
So you're going to, I use, firstly, also I want to know whether, you know, what, if you've done the math around the kind of savings you'll have from this corporate tax deductions, and then if you're saying that capacity expansion additions is any which way is an ongoing process, then the additional windfall that you're getting in terms of this tax savings, would that be directed someplace else, or would that sit on the sit on the books?
So we are going to be significant gainers of corporate tax reduction, because we were practically in the top tax bracket of 34.9%. And with the corporate tax reduction is going to come out to around 25.2. So it's a significant gain for us. So part of it is going to get deployed in our capexes, and part of it is going to sit on our balance sheet.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So Mr. Lal, for this capex that you are saying, which is an ongoing process, is there a large capex lined up in the current financial year itself? And would you be sufficiently funded because of internal cash flows or the tax benefits otherwise, or would you contemplate raising any kind of monies for the same?
So in this year also, the capex plan is around 60-65 crores, and we have enough internal accruals, and after this capex also we're going to generate a reasonable amount of free cash. So in this fiscal, I'm not seeing any funds being raised either through debt or equity. We have enough strength in the balance sheet to do it on our own. Next year, let's see. We have some expansion plans in existing and new product categories, and possibly we're going to look at some kind of small long-term debt.
One final question, and I agree you are in a silent period, so you really can't talk too much, but your answer got me intrigued. When you're talking about new customer acquisitions, are you talking about game-changing customers coming in which might give a fillip to the top line over the course of the next few years, or this is a string of pearls strategy that will work out over the, I mean, in the near term?
So we keep working on large accounts, we keep working on accounts which are not as large. All of them are equally important to us. If you see our strategy in lighting, that is what we have been able to successfully implement in lighting. We have been able to do that to a large extent in our washing machine business. So I'm not in a position to share that what kind of accounts we are working upon. Yeah, but they're all both large and big. So that's a continuous exercise.